Good evening. I hope that you are well. And I'm happy to be doing this video for you. There's been a lot of obstacles. In order to give this information to you and help you relax. So we're going to talk about the third chakra, which is yellow. And it can be called the solar plexus chakra, the sacral chakra, and in Sanskrit it is called the Manipura chakra. This chakra embodies how you perceive yourself. Therefore, it is to do with the ego. When this chakra is unbalanced, so the gift of this chakra, or this energy force within you, is to come in alignment with your own personal power, in whatever way that may occur. You know, I used to be very unsure of myself, and I used to always have to run my decisions past other people because I didn't trust myself to make the right decisions. But now it means that when I make a decision about anything, I feel liberated and completely free in knowing that I am my own spiritual guide and teacher in a way. You see, everything is possible through the self. Anything that I or you once make happen in life, only you can make happen for yourself. Because when you start to realize that you can transform those thoughts of yours, those dreams, hopes, into action, then you start to realize that truly is mind over matter. Because our mind creates everything, even matter itself. Therefore, we have complete power. All is the mind, and that is what this third chakra is trying to remind us. It's trying to remind us just how powerful and grand we are. And so when we use this energy in a balanced way, we come into our personal power and we start realizing our lives. Our life's purpose. If we are to consciously we are to be productive instead of reactive to our circumstances. The more we are able to just let life flow and not severely judge everything that happens to us, the more we are in alignment with the universal force that is all. That is all. So, to have this third chakra of balance would mean that your reactions to life are excessive. You may have emotional outbursts. And one way is to be passive or inactive, and you could do this by thinking that the world just does things to you and you have no power over it. You may also believe that you're a victim to karma or past life experiences. Who knows? But all you're doing there is taking the power away from yourself. Decide to live life as an active but balanced controller of your life. If you have So, the message of this third chakra is so what do you choose? Do you choose to live out your life and your purpose? Or do you choose to be a passive observer and believe that life just happens to you? Because no matter what happens in life, no matter how bad or how good, you can always choose how to react and how to grow from it and how to have a better life in every situation. The sense of freedom when you can choose for you only what you want to do in life is wonderful. And so it is about developing because every time you judge or criticize yourself, you are in turn taking the power away from yourself. You are taking away the power of the sacral chakra. Instead, you simply need to greet yourself with love. You need to really love yourself in order to no longer judge every single thing that you do. And this will give rise to acceptance of who you are. And it will ignite the third chakra. Because you are the one who creates your destiny. Person with an open and balanced Manipura chakra is confident in their ability and is able to express themselves powerfully because they know who they are. So, the power is always with you to choose. to become one with ourselves again. Thank you so much for being on this journey with me. Tonight was a full moon, and I had so many difficult experiences today, but after reading about the third chakra, I realized that it's in my power to react in a more understanding way to the things that happen, either to me or in the world, and it's so helpful. It takes away the anger and the sadness, and that is why I wanted to share it with you, as always. Well, and I hope you begin to really believe in yourself and have love for yourself. There is no more room for insecurity in this world. We have enough of it. We need people in this world who can come together and really be who they are. The world would be amazing if we all did this. If we all worked on the capacity and scale of who and what we are really capable of. Currently, humanity does not live in all that we are individually capable of.